Well, I'm just the moderator. Sorry for that. Next time we're going to bring some dancer on stage.
Okay. Sure. So now whatever we
okay,
say.
Okay, so can you please mute the mics and open your video cameras so we can fix all the technical issues here first. Thank you.
This.
So I don't know about you. I came prepared. I hope you too.
Me too. Okay. Tanis. Oh. Okay. Okay, so I guess now everyone is here and we are already live streaming through all social media. So we are ready to kick off this most important day of the past 4 months. Welcome everyone in the demo day of UPLIFT Albania second edition. My name is Mary Roboci. I am the UPLIFT coordinator, and today it is also my pleasure to host you through this evening. Actually, the event feels quite different comparing to last year when there were no empty seats in front of me. But again, we are delighted to know that behind the screens, you are all joining us in this celebration for all over the world. So we are very excited to see some of the top performing Albanian startups pitch today on stage. I would like, of course, to start this evening by sharing a bit of UPLIFT story, especially for all of you that have just recently joined our network. So for all of you that, okay, I think I have an issue, a bit of issue here with the presentation. Guys, apologize us while we're live streaming for all of this, but this makes it more interesting, I guess. It feels more real for all of you. Okay, so okay, that's great. I didn't want to miss all these logos for all of you to see because they are quite important for all of us, for all the innovation ecosystem in Albania. So UPLIFT, as you already know, is an early stage startups accelerator, but this very important brand stands inside the family of other highly important brands of Albanian innovation ecosystem. And they are all standing tall under the umbrella of ICTS Media's company. ICTS Media company is founded back in 2012. And since then, it never lost focus from one of the most important missions, that is tech media, tech education, entrepreneurship, and innovation for social impact in general. Over the past year, ICTS Media brought to Albania some of the top performing brands and projects, and you can see a few of them behind me in the slide. And just to mention a few, ICTS Lab has recently turned into the favorite lab for the youngest generation of innovators in Albania, offering tech education for 21st century skill for kids till professionals. And ICT Awards is known in our network as the Oscars in ICT for Albanian, offering the highest individual recognition. And just to go on with other projects, I'm sure that you all have probably heard of them offering innovation in social impact to change the and fix all those challenges that a small country like ours faces in daily basis. While Uplift is just 2 years old, the relationship of ICTS Media with startups has dated quite back since the first event of ICT Awards. And now we are very proud to represent 20 plus success stories from ICT Awards, which are now translated into companies of a billion companies worth all over the world. And as proud we are to present to you the first cohort of Uplift, who are the startups that first graduated this accelerator last year. And today they have successfully closed several rounds of investments. And the most important ones for today are this cohort graduates: Wellness Plus, Crossplag, Hermet, Swiping, Inegotio, Ooth, NutriPrep, and AlbNB are coming today in stage after 4 months of intensive accelerating journey, when they have been challenged in all the business aspects, creating all the necessary needed skills to grow this business, creating the right pitching skill set to rock this stage today. And this, of course, was done through a high caliber pool of mentors who we were honored to have from all over the world as part of Uplift. I would like to give a big thank you to all of you, our mentors that you can see behind me. Without you and without finding the time in your busy agendas to support our startups, this journey would of course not have been possible. And the same big thank you goes to our partners who made this journey in a challenging year very much easier for all of us. They always make our best much better. So thank you to all of you. And last, but of course not least, I would like to appreciate the team behind Uplift. It's always a very great pleasure to work with all of you guys. And from them, I would like to invite the one person of our team who always guide us through uplifting, the managing partner of ICTS Media, Mr. Kushtrim Shala. Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Mary, for the great introduction. Hello, everyone. It's a great pleasure to see this international scheme, this international audience. It's a great pleasure, and this is thanks to a great work for 2 years. Before 2 years, actually, we had ICT Awards. We managed to raise the attraction of local stakeholders such as Vodafone, Raiffeisen, and so many actors that were part of this initiative. And then it comes another moment that we needed some more spaces. Albania were a little bit small for us, so we tried to expose our talents. We try to expose even Albania towards the international scene. So thanks to Uplift and thanks to especially Slovak Aid, Sova, which are our co-organizers at this event. Thanks to them, we managed to bring to Albania an international event such as Uplift Albania. Uplift actually is being organized in Slovakia for so many years. Now it has been transformed into Challenger Accelerator, and we couldn't find a better, partner or supporter rather than Sova and their friends at Civita, who helped us, who brought us a lot of expertise and increases the capacities of our team. So I think that you guys have done the mission. Thank you very much for the great job you have done. So I think that we are now independent to organize such international events. Today, we are going to show a video. I didn't want to take so much from my side, so much speeches and so much work from my side. So I would like actually to bring a video, a 3-minute video, before I would give the microphone to our great friend, our mayor of Tirana, a great supporter, a fantastic leader of our city, Mr. Ion Veliai. So let's please see the video, join us to see this video, and then pass the microphone to Mr. Veliai and then Mr. Shalsi, and the show will go on. Thank you so much. A big applause to the audience. I'm one of those who believe that startups is one of the greatest forms of organizations to make the world a better place. The past few decades, the world has seen an unprecedented level of innovation, especially in software, internet, and mobile technology. As part of ICDS Media, being one of the actors in this regional ecosystem, we felt some personal responsibility of the level of innovation in our country. Of course, alone we weren't able to do everything, but we could help to grow the startup ecosystem and also saturate the culture of the right motivations for startups being a startup.
Crossplay is an edtech company that aims to try and solve one big problem, which is translated pleasures.
Wellness Plus is an online platform who aims to help chiefs and fitness clubs to manage their business.
Booth is a startup based in Barcelona. We help mostly commuters and also students.
I am a service provider that aims to provide for
humanity and beyond. Nutripera is a company that offers ready-to-eat meals and customizable meal plans.
Swiping is a mobile social shopping app.
Hermes is a startup designed to help businesses build their professional e-commerce website.
Welcome to the demo day of UPLIFT ALBANIA 2020-21 edition. Today, you will see not just founders pitching the business ideas, but a combination of 4 months of work, hundreds of hours of shaping their businesses' models, and becoming the ones who aspire to change their country. May the best win.
Hopefully this gave you a vibe of how UPLIFT journey was like. And as Kushtrim mentioned, this uplifting journey was of course easier in a city that is turning rapidly in a creative digital space. So let's welcome the mayor of Tirana for his words.
Thank you so much. The last time I was here, I'm gonna say a few words to our international friends who are online, and then a few words to our Albanian friends who are limited, but are here in physical space. But I remember I was joking with Christine, because the last time I left, I was abroad, was the 11th of March last year. And we were to see Peter in Bratislava and Slovakia. And then they closed down on that day because the mayor and the prime minister of Slovakia had to shut down all the events and all the activities when they had their early infections. And then the moment we landed here, we went through the phase of lockdown. So my last memories of encountering civilization in person was with Peter and the friends in Slovakia. So good to see you again online. And I hope time returns where we can do this back and forth in physical space as well, not just in digital space. It has been a year of trouble, but I think it's also been a year of amazing opportunity. And we found out that those knowledge-based economies, despite the pandemic, were the economies that made it just fine, despite the difficulties. You know, of course, they were under the constraints of COVID, but the creativity, the time people spend in innovation was very well spent. And you can see countries like Estonia and Slovakia and Israel, they weathered the storm because they invested in knowledge. And I'm going to switch to Albanian because it refers to also some of our difficulties, you know, with the earthquake. You know, the earthquake can destroy stuff, but the earthquake or the flood or the pandemic, they cannot destroy knowledge. And that's why we also need to be startup nations. You know, we are one nation as Albanians, but I am so proud to find out that the finalists come both from Albania and Kosovo. So I'm going to switch to Albanian just very briefly. Për t'ju thënë sa krenar jam për gjithë djemt, edhe vajzat, nga Shqipëria dhe nga Kosova, më lumturon pa mas, fakti që kemi mbritur deri këtu. Dhe kur përshkoja kalendarin, se si kishit filluar në fillim, ku ishte data e parë, regjistrimi ishte në gusht, diku, dhe kur shikoj se si tani jeni ke hapi fundit, ka jo diagrama që kishit quar tek ftesa, do thotë, ja ku është një grup me njërës se ka kalu kohën kotë. Se jam I sigur që edhe se cili për jush mund thoshte u çmenë me pandeminë, ky tërmeti na ka bërë gjithë me depresion, po fakti që zgjodhët që në mënyrë kreative të mendonit për këto ide që mund të financohen dhe nesër mund të bëhen ide globale dhe mund të bëhen tentativa të shkëlqyra të suksesshme për biznes, më inkurajon jashtë masë. Edhe jam shumë krenar për se cilin për jush. Unë e di sa e vështirë është, sidomos në këtë ekosistem, se folëm për ekosistemet, në ekosistemin ton ku sipërmarrësi akoma quhet matrapas, ku 9 nga 10 veta thonë duan punojmë në shtet, ku fjalët tipike janë shtyhet dhe zbohet. Fakti që kemi mbrit deri këtu realisht më mbush me shumë inkurajim, sepse do të thotë që ne jemi një tokë pjellore për këto ide. Kam parë shumë ide që kanë lulëzuar edhe në Shqipëri edhe në Kosovë. Mbaj mend kur jemi takuar në fillim fare që nga kohë kur punonim në ministri, edhe kur sot shikoj se si disa nga ato ide timide të atyre korave janë bërë sot fantastike, duke filluar nga taksit elektrike që I kemi pasur në konkurim, duke filluar nga babun, ku unë porosis drekë në dhushimin që harrukve dhe që babun im gjenë ku do të jem në cep, apo shumë prej gjirafa që me shpresë shumë shpejt mërgimi do marrë I shtetësin shqiptare dhe do jetë edhe këtej dhe andej me këtë sipërmarrje, më bënd të kuptoj që I kemi mundësi dhe kemi talente. Tani, qa mund të bëj unë, qa mund të bëj qyteti? Spari më shumë infrastrukturë. Momentalisht po kaloja, vazhdojmë punime tek piramida, do punojmë gjithë këtë vit që Tumo të ketë shpinë e vetë, dhe të ketë hapsirën e vetë, ku të ketë mundësi çdo fëmijë nga mosha 12 deri në 18 të futet në këtë botë. Por, mënyra se si do të andajmë piramidën, do tjetë 1/3 do tjetë hapsirë për mësim, pra për nxënje, pjesa tjetër do jetë hapsirë për organizata si tuajat, pra për upliftin, për ICTS media, që të bëhet praktika dhe të inkubohen idetë, kurse pjesën tjetër do ta lëmë për kompanitë e biznesit, sa për tyre keni sponsora, kompani mediatike, kompani IT-e dhe telekomunikacioni, dhe unë them nëse e lidhim këtë ekosistem të hapësirës fizike, me këto mundësi, ne mund të bëjmë një histori suksesi tek piramida. Për ta mbyllur, do mundohemi që në të 29 shkollat e reja, 17 në dhe 12 qeveria, të fusim pjesën fuqishën, pjesën e laboratorëve të IT-s. Jo si një hapsir periferike, si një loj apendiciti, një zorë qore që ti e ke aty hajtë se kemi dhe ca kompjutera, po ajo duhet jetë zemreku I shkollave që kemi në vizionin tonë. Dhe ndaj shpresoj shumë fort që do ju kemi në kra, ku ne të bëjmë atë që ndodhë sot në Izrael. Izraeli si startup nation, apo Slovakia me projektet e bugra që pam, I kam suar fëmijët që në moshtë vogël të mendojnë si sipërmarrës, dhe jo si diku që eventualisht do punoj për shtetin. Kur kujtoj historitë se si nisi Airbnb-a me Brian edhe Joe, që nuk gjetën vend në hotel në San Francisco, morën disa jastëk ose dyshek ajri, dhe air bed and breakfast, dhe nga Airbnb-a e famshme, vetëm me $20,000 kanë krijuar sot një kompani e cila ka revenues të ardhura më shumë se sa gjithë zinxhirët kryesor të hoteleve. Do thot fuqia e ideve të mira. Dhe unë shpresoj fort, disa për jush ndoshta jeni në punë diku, por kur më kujtohet ideja e Apple-it, nuk ishte Steve Jobs I gjeniu, ishte The Woz, Steve Wozniak. Dhe Steve Wozniak në fakt tashmë punonte për HP-n, për Hewlett Packard. dhe insistonte, kam gjetë një sistem të ri, ju lutëm, jo, jemi mirë me HP-në. Dhe ndonjëherë duhet dalësh nga zona komforti dhe të shkosh në një ekosistem, siç ishte ai Steve Jobsit që tha, le të bëjmë Apple-in. Kështu që cilido qoftë rrugtimi juaj, jam I lumtur që keni mbritur sot në Tiranë për këtë eksperiencë fantastike. Ju uroj shumë sukses dhe jam pa dyshim, e kam dhënë me prova këtë, fans juaj më I madh. Shumë faleminderit.
Faleminderit. So now I would like to hand over to the next very important person that also Kushtrim mentioned, our partners in Slovakia who are helping us in building this bridge between the both ecosystem. Please, Executive Director at Solva, Mr. Daniel Straka, for your word.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, good evening, friends. Mira brema mis. It's a big pleasure for me to that we can meet at UPLIFT Albania second edition of Demo Day. Unfortunately, as was mentioned, the current circumstances do not allow us to be with you in Tirana personally. I remember very clearly the vibrant atmosphere from last year, where there was like almost 200 people during the first grand final of the first edition a year ago. However, this is the role of the innovators to cross all the challenges, to find a solution in every situation. And thanks to innovation, also this event can take place. This is the result of our project that we have together with ICTS Lab in Albania. And the main goal of our project is education and improvement of support mechanism for young entrepreneurs and startups in Albania, as well as preparing the startups and young entrepreneurs for businesses by intense and practical training. Oops. These descriptions are boring and official. To be honest, what we want to do is to support young, enthusiastic entrepreneurs in Albania in their dream to start their own businesses. That's the main goal of our project. And I think that we are doing this. We in Sova believe that a big change does not necessarily need big money. And this project proved it. With small amount of funding, but with enthusiastic people on both sides, startups and mentors, we are making big change. We think that all the startups also become role models and inspiration of change for others, mainly young people in Albania. It's our hope that the young people will stay in Albania, not only because they love their country, which they really do, but also because the condition for entrepreneurship will attract them enough to choose to stay. We also believe that the talents are the most important commodity for the future. You know that in Albania, you don't have huge natural resources, but you have young and talented people. And every time I visited Albania, I have met a lot of talented women and men. Let me take the opportunity to thank to all my colleagues in Slovakia, Jakub, Martina, Peter, Michal, Eva, Jaro, Martin, Tomáš and Kristina, and to all the partners that allows that this project could happen, mainly to Slovagate, which is the main donor of the project. But the big thanks go to Kushtrim and his team and all the experts from Albania and also from Slovakia. And as we can see also from other countries, without all of you, this will never happen. This project will end in a month, but we have already started a new one called Bridge to EU, which will bring Albanian startups to Slovakia for a soft landing program, giving them opportunity for growth and new partnerships, again, thanks to Slovagate. So I believe that there will be plenty of opportunities to meet you personally, either in Albania in the coming years or in Slovakia, of course, when all of us will be vaccinated, which I hope will be very soon. I wish all the luck to 9 finalists. You have already made a long way and a longer and hard ways before you, but that's what you have signed up for. You should always have in your mind a sentence written by the famous Albanian philosopher Sami Frashëri. The mistakes made while doing something you love are better than the perfection created while doing something you don't like. Miru pavshin mis. Goodbye, friends.
Thank you very much. Now, here in Albania, Uplift is not the only one who is focused in empowering the startups ecosystem. We also have the state by our side. So I would like to hand over now to the Minister of State for Entrepreneurship Protection, Mr. Eduard Shalsi.
Hello, everybody. Hello. I apologize for not being there physically, but I'm speaking from my constituency, from a beautiful city called Pokrades, where major forces kept me here. The Prime Minister visited my constituency, and I was obliged to accompany him during his visits. Hello, the ones who are present there, but also my friends, old ones like Jacqueline, and to the newest one, Catran. I'm very glad that Uplift Albania is now at this stage. For the ones who don't know me, I'm the Minister for Protection of the Enterprise, which is unusual. You cannot find it elsewhere. I'm protecting the business from my own government. So I have one leg in the business, one leg in the government. I'm fighting with the bureaucracy within the government in protections of the rights of the entrepreneurships. It's a role due to the circumstances in Albania, which is undergoing a lot of reforms, on top of which is justice reform. But during these 2 years serving as a minister, I've come across to many ideas. I've met a lot of people, but I'll never forget when the young group of people came to my office and said, "We need a law and we need some policies for the startup." So it was not within my duties, my responsibilities, but I saw this gap and I took the advantage of consulting myself with other arms of the government. And thanks to the EU for Innovation program, we started a process, and now I'm very happy to say that we have a draft law on startups. As a matter of fact, it's not our law, it's your law. If it was not for you, we would have taken a lot of time to understand that it was necessary. Since I last spoke to Uplift, you know, we were just at the brainstorming process. Now, I'm very happy that we have a law which is already it's ready, and it will be submitted to the Parliament of Albania. If it was not for the process that we carefully designed on involving the existing community, you know, the guys involved in the startups were much better prepared than the bureaucracy within the government. And what I have done was that I was closing the gap between different state institutions and your talented community. And I really want to thank you for your efforts. And I really want to thank all the actors of the existing ecosystems, which made government more aware of the possibilities and opportunities that this community can offer. And in terms of, you know, jobs, but also enhancing a new culture. You know, it is among the best communities I've ever met in Albania. And I'm very encouraged to go on. I'm not going to go into details with the law, but we have taken into considerations all suggestions, complaints of the communities, and we've come across to some very talented Albanians who are living abroad, but have been deeply involved in startup systems. But these efforts allowed us to know some very talented people abroad. And I'm very delighted that you know, we are at the start of a very interesting journey, and we're very committed to involve. And one last thing I'm going to say. It was a very big debate among the different state-owned agencies about the board members of Startup Albania. Jacqueline knows that how we were fighting with the state bureaucrats, but it finally we made it that the majority of the board will be dependent from the ecosystems. So the state will be not in majority, because we truly believe that in your hands, it's better at the moment for the ecosystems rather than governments' hands. Thank you very much for making us part. As a matter of fact, I look back a year ago, I didn't have any idea about the startups. For us, startups was a new business, right? Now you have broadened, and you have shown that through closing the gap between state-owned institutions and private sectors, it helps a lot. And we're very committed, and we encourage you to go on and play the role that you can play and the government cannot substitute. Thank you very much. I want to thank each of you for your contributions, and we look forward to cooperate with you in the future.
Thank you very much for always being supportive to our startups. Now, as also Kushtrim shared a bit in the beginning, UPLIFT has many secrets, but one of the most important ones was the opportunity to learn from some very great partner that we have in Bratislava. And from Civita, I would like to hand over the word to Mr. Peter Kolesar.
Thank you, Mary. I hope you can hear me.
Yes,
hi, it's great. It's great to be back. I have to say, even though remotely, I remember very vividly to be on that stage just a year ago in that great and impressive theater in the first demo day. And you and the team around Kushtrim and ICTS Media have done an amazing job cultivating entrepreneurs and organizing these public presentations, which demo days are. And of course, today we have to meet like this. This is kind of a hybrid event, which is the toughest thing to organize, by the way, for organizers. Not many people realize that, but this is not easy. So congrats and really thumbs up for that. And as Arion has mentioned, just 3 weeks after I was on that stage, so after we visited Tirana and actually received a wonderful license plate of Tirana 100 years on behalf of the entire Slovak team. Just 3 weeks afterwards, Arion came to Bratislava to meet with the mayor, visit the universities. And when we were having dinner together, just that evening, basically Corona started for us. This was the evening when we realized this is going to seriously affect our lives. And coincidentally, you know, that day is associated with Arion's visit to Slovakia, unfortunately. But you managed, you know, to pull this off against, I would say, the very difficult situation of doing things remotely or partly remotely online. So congratulations. And I'm really happy that UPLIFT has become kind of a platform for joint you know, collaboration between Slovaks and Albanians. And now, of course, we have included Israel as well in the person of Tal in the jury. So very happy to be expanding this collaboration to other countries as well. And thanks to your work, and thanks also to the work of politicians like Eduard or like Arion, Tirana is being noticed. Tirana is being noticed by the hard work of the community, which is helping entrepreneurs, and also by the public support that we have seen. And this is what a functioning startup ecosystem needs to see: the partnership between the public sector and the private sector, between corporates and startups, and between the academia. So I'm really happy that we see that in Albania. And of course, Tirana's superstar mayor, Arion Veliaj, is doing an amazing job to really be the best ambassador for young people, for young entrepreneurs coming out of Tirana. And you should really value that that person being an ambassador for all of you, not only in Albania, but really around Europe. So good luck to all the startups pitching this evening. This is a serious final for all your hard work in the past 4 months. Good luck to the jury members that will be asking questions. We're always here to help you in the journey, but also selfishly, we're here to get inspired by the work of ICTS Media and also by the work of all the startups that we will see on stage today. So stay to be challengers.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your word. And as we are all looking forward to the most exciting part of today, some of the personalities in between us are in a more difficult position because they need to evaluate and to identify the top performing startups in these 8 graduates. I would like now to present the jury, which is a quite diverse jury from Tirana to Bratislava to Skopje to Michigan, everywhere. And of course, the center of startups ecosystem, let's say, from Tel Aviv. We have this very diverse jury that I would kindly ask one after the other to give a word to startups before they start pitching here for you on stage. Mr. Andrei Petrus, investment manager at SVO at Zaka Startup Venture Capital.
Hello, everyone.
Hello. We would like a very short intro from your side so startups can know a bit more about their journey today.
Sure. So I'm from Zaka Startups. We are a private venture capital fund operating mainly in Czech Republic and Slovakia. I'm sitting in Prague, and we are investing mainly in the pre-seed, seed, and Series A stage, so in the earliest stages. And that's why I'm really happy to be here and looking forward to see the final pitches today. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And next is Ms. Viola Pucci, Head of Corporate Affairs and Foundation at Vodafone Albania.
Hi, everyone. This is one of those very few places that I very much enjoy to be in. And I'm honored to be in the jury. I'm happy that I don't have to introduce Vodafone much because the brand introduces itself. But I want to say that even a big corporation such as Vodafone, it has now a different vision for the future. It wants to change from a telco company to a techno company. And that means the technology, it will be at the heart of what we do. And when it comes to technology, it's the support that the future will be giving to all the startups out there. And I want to let everyone know that this is not the end of the journey. This is just the start of a long journey into the business idea, the entrepreneurial ways of thinking. And I wish all of you to make it, but even if you don't make it, you will still come out of this journey knowing quite a lot of things, knowing that hard work at some point in life will get you there. Thank you.
Thank you. And we have also Ms. Elizabetska, Senior Associate at Seoul Central Ventures.
Thank you, Mary. Hello, everyone. Good evening. It's a great pleasure to be here with you also on the second batch, as I was also present in the first one. I want to congratulate all of you behind this organization, because, and I hope you will continue in the future, because I strongly believe that you make a strong impact to the local ecosystem of Albania and also of the neighboring countries. Yes, I'm part of South Central Ventures, which is the manager of the Enterprise Innovation Fund. It's a standalone VC fund operating out of four offices within the region, from Skopje, Belgrade, Zagreb, and Ljubljana. From Skopje office, where I'm based, we cover also the markets of Albania and Kosovo. And yes, I would just like to say to the startups, I've met some of you during our mentoring sessions, but still collaboration is a big part of making a successful business. So let's keep the communication channel open between all of us and feel free to reach out even after tonight. And of course, good luck to everyone.
Thank you very much. And from Tel Aviv, Mr. Tal Catran.
Hey, hi everyone. Wow, so much energy and vibration. If you were to tell me, I would spend Friday, which is our resting day, doing a demo day jury in Albania, I would tell you you're crazy, you're out of your mind. But listen, this is what it is. And I'm so happy to be here. Amazingly enough, knowing at least half of the jury, Jacob Mudir, who first introduced me to Macedonia, Edward, the minister, which I can vouch for, is doing amazing work for this ecosystem to build up. Andre, Peter, which I'm sure we will do business later. And of course, Kushtrim, who is the engine of what's going on here. Really, a big, big applause to you all. It's amazing to be here. Since the startups right now are about to become unconscious anyway, they will not remember anything from what we're all saying. I will just say briefly, it's an honor to be here, a great pleasure. This is for me a debut. I'm sure I'm gonna visit more also physically. I wanna wish everyone great success today to all the startups. Enjoy today, try to remember a little bit, but you know what, we are recording, so you can enjoy it also later. Success to everyone, thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Tal Catran, and another important personality, Mr. Eddie Demai from Michigan.
Hey guys, Eddie Demai, co-founder at Code Labs and partner at ZeroAlpha, which I'm sure a lot of you guys know. Had the pleasure of meeting some of you. Very, very excited to kind of see the Albanian startup ecosystem and, you know, growing as I've, you know, been a part of it and following it for some years now. Best of luck today, and look forward to continue to talk to some of you guys afterwards as well.
Thank you. And last but of course not least, we have Mr. Boris Zeleny, entrepreneur and philanthropist.
Hi, everyone. It's a great honor, again, to be part of this jury. Last year in Tirana, I enjoyed very much the energy, the quality of the startups, all the ecosystem. So I'm very happy to join again this time. Fingers crossed for everybody, for all the startups. And let's get started. Thank you. Best regards.
Thank you very much to all the jury, and good luck today in your difficult task, let's say. And now from this moment, I'm very happy to leave this stage to the ones that we all gathered to see. And how this will work, you already know. We're gonna have the 3+3 minute speech. I will invite you all one after the other for the 3 minutes presentation, and then you're gonna have the time for the 3 minutes question and answers from the jury. And before I invite the first one, I don't want to be saying cliches and say that you are all winners, because you really don't need to hear that from me. You already can feel the growth in yourself, in your business, in your network. So let's see this final ending as a sweet ending of many new beginnings from all of you today. So the first one will bring a hobby that I guess we all have and miss recently, that of traveling. So let's wait startup Ulf for the first pitch. Yes, you're ready. We're just getting ready our pitch, and we're gonna start. Anas.
Okay. 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 I think we're
okay.
Ready.
Please stay there in the center so okay, you can yes. be more okay. So your time
hello,
starts
everyone.
Now.
I am Errol Gursi from UTheme. UTheme is a carpooling platform based on its community. So what we're trying to do with UTheme is give everyone a free seat filled with good company. This all started with us as students traveling from our hometown to the city that we studied. And we were struggling to find a good alternative of traveling while staying for hours in full buses. To tackle down this problem, we created a community of people with whom we could travel with. And after analyzing the needs and behaviors of this community, we decided to create an application that lets passengers reserve a seat and also drivers post a ride. This community was just a sample of a whole market that is waiting for our solution out there. And according to our estimation, the total market in the Western Balkans is around 4.8 billion euros. And we're looking to penetrate only 0.3 of that target, that is 14 million euros. Penetrating this market will be easy since UTheme offers the commodity and also the travel speed of a taxi while paying a comparable price to the ones of bus and trains. Our business model will be a little bit different as we bootstrap our startups. So if you ask me what's the ideal way to make revenue of this idea, I would answer transaction fees. But till we reach a balance between supply and demand, because we're dealing with a two-sided market, we are going to acquire clients that have storefronts and use them as our meeting points. So every time a travel starts from one of the points of our clients, they will pay us a fixed fee. If we look the UPLIFT journey, when we started, we had 11,000 community members. But if we fast forward today, during our journey, we have released our app and we'll also define our business model. If we look at the numbers now, we are counting more than 16,000 members in our community and more than 2,000 active users in our application. To make all this possible, we've gathered a team of two developers, one UI UX specialist, and we also brought the knowledge of an MBA graduate right from Golden Gate University of San Francisco. So what we're looking today is to get 50,000 of investment for 10% of our shares. We will use them to penetrate the Albanian market and also to automate the client onboarding process. I think this is all. Thank you for your attention, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions.
Hi. First of all, very nice presentation. You had a very good flow and it was very clear, although for us, the presentation didn't move. So they owe you something there. Can you please speak a little bit about the business model? How are you making money?
Yes. In fact, no, we're not making revenue yet, but we're close to closing our first deal with the first client. So it's a very big client from Kosovo that has more than 50 points in seven different cities of Kosovo.
Okay, and what would be the business model? How will you make the money?
The business model will be, we will integrate the client's points into our applications. And every time a trip starts, it will have a meeting point. That meeting point will be one of our client's storefronts. And that will be a value that we give to the client. So he will have the chance to get marketing and also a possibility to have a conversion from our user to their customer.
Okay, thank you. Good luck.
Thank you.
We have other 2 minutes for other questions.
I have a quick question, if I may. So I understand the marketing, one revenue channel with, by marketing businesses on your platform, essentially indirectly, which I think is unique and cool. But do you ever plan on taking the transaction fee out of the, from either side when you do integrate with that? And one and two, like what payment platform are you actually going to integrate? Because I'm not sure what's actually available there. I'm just curious.
Yes, we will integrate online payments in the first stable release of our application. So we're now on beta testing. We will first release as an optional form of paying. So the driver will make the decision if he want to receive cash or online payments. And there are a few providers in Kosovo, like banks, and also there are new financial institutions like Paysera or others that are integrating in the Kosovan market. And we will use one of them to make this done.
In the last 30 seconds, another question, or
this? Yeah, maybe I can go. Okay. They were all a very nice presentation. So are there any requirements of who can be the driver in some trip and how many travels were realized so far, since you've mentioned quite a number of community members and active members?
Yes, I'm going to be fast. So there are 15 drives per day, and also the requirements are that the user, in fact, there are no requirements. We don't divide passengers and drivers. We just require for them to verificate themselves with ID. We have almost 100 users that are verified till now.
Okay, thank you. This was 3+3 minutes for you, but I can see that there was some technical problem with the slides. So I would kindly ask the jury and also you, if you want to share the slides in a one more minute, or if jury wants to add questions, so we fix this for you. Okay, what do you think? You want to reshare the slides, or you're going to leave it up to jury?
I think there was only one slide missing. So if the jury wants to see it, we can go over it again.
Okay. Can you just go to the slide that you want to?
I think we were sharing the, we shared the business model, the progress timeline.
Just 1 second so it can be fixed.
Just to be clear, what part did you see from my presentation? If you could.
Is something unclear still from the jury? So Errol can reshare the slide that you probably missed in his presentation.
I think we're done. I think it's okay.
You're this good, was all the, of you?
This was the main photo the picture that we saw, but it was nice.
Okay.
Didn't see much of the presentation, but if we have time for one more question, so I would like to ask.
Okay, yes. Sure.
How did you calculate the potential market size, and which countries did you include here?
We've calculated the total number of destinations that are available in Western Balkans. So starting from Kosovo, Albania, Montenegro, Macedonia, Serbia, and also Bulgaria. And we've tried to estimate the number of travelers that can happen in this region, and we've come up with this number. So,
thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Errol. Good job. Now, if you are all looking for a platform that you can create online stores with just one click, this is the right business for you. So let's welcome Hermex. Okay, just 1 minute so we fix the sharing. Can the jury see the presentation? Okay, so
Hello, everybody. I am Nayada, co-founder at Hermex. Hermex is an e-commerce platform that enables businesses to create their online store with one click. Due to pandemic situation, last year was dramatic. Thousands of businesses went bankrupt and millions of people went jobless, and the situation is still ongoing. Businesses have to go from bricks to clicks as soon as possible in order to survive the crisis. Retail habits have changed once and for all. While in Albania, this is the current situation of e-commerce. Existing solutions lack secure online payments, are slow, and have a bad user experience. That's why we created Hermex, create your online store with one click. How it works, you can register with your email and store name. You can access the dashboard to add the products and start selling immediately. Here are some of our clients. In addition to Albania, we managed to expand in US and Greece. Why Hermex? We offer smooth user experience. We save you money and time. We offer dedicated support, custom features and designs on demand, and high performance and security. E-commerce is booming, and the market size is estimated to reach $27 trillion by 2027. And our business model, we are a SaaS platform that charge through subscription, custom features, and transaction fees. Our main competitors are Shopify, WooCommerce, Wix, etc. But we are the first local company that does what these global companies do. Our competitive advantages, we offer a professional e-commerce platform at a competitive price, custom features and designs on demand, and dedicated support to configure and grow your online store. In Albania, in addition, we offer local support, secure online payments in dashboard in Albanian language. We started our road toward this journey in August 2020. We have now 6 paying clients, and we aim to reach 100 satisfied clients within a year. During this roadmap, we joined UPLIFT, which helped us double our traction, grew our network, and win Elevator Lab. We are a team of 6, mainly technical persons, and that's why we are looking for partnership, mainly in marketing and sales, in order to continue our mission toward professional e-commerce. Thank you.
You are in your last 20 seconds, but we can give that time to the question and answers part, adding that to the 3 minutes. So, Jordi, the word is to you.
Boosting digital channels is where the world is moving towards. But you have to make sure that in Albania, the customer, it's a bit particular. We don't usually follow the trends of digital marketing, and we are the sort of customer that would like to line up in stores. So how would you like to change that mentality in order to sustain your business case?
Okay, it's obvious that a lot of businesses now are shifting toward online from bricks to clicks. I know that in Albania we haven't evolved as much as in Europe or US, but we also are a bit late with this. But that's why we are here, because we want to revolutionize that. We are negotiating with, after winning Elevator Lab, with Raiffeisen Bank, because we want to offer secure online payments and to make trust, to build trust in people here in Albania and region. But we are not only focused here, because we want to expand also in EU and US later.
So you have currently 6 paying customers. How do you acquire your customers? What's the go-to-market strategy?
Sorry, Andrei, can you repeat it once more?
Yeah, sorry. So you currently have 6 paying customers.
Yes.
And how do you acquire, or how do you plan to acquire new customers?
Okay, these customers, we acquired them through our network and recommendations and contacting one-to-one businesses here in Albania. But that's why we're here, because we are looking for partnership in order to help us to raise our base client or investment.
I have a quick question. So one, great presentation. I love what you guys are doing. I think you guys are up to something really, really big. So I'm really excited to see you guys grow. But two, you mentioned something about potentially going outside of just the Albania market. Can you speak to that at all? Like, have you looked into that at all? Or is it more of like, you want to make sure you really get things right in Albania before you actually like try to go outside?
Yes, we want to start in Albania to improve the market here, to build a good base of clients, to improve our solution, and then to go worldwide.
I think you should definitely go with Albania. I've seen maybe 100 countries. They all have their own apps, very similar, just because now to stay alive, everyone taps into the digital, and you have done a great move for Albania, first of all, and then also for you guys. I just want to tell you that to answer, sorry, I don't remember the name from Vodafone, I think, Viola, is that the problem is that small businesses are technophobic and they don't want to deal with anything. And another problem that they are not tapping into is actually the marketing writing. So they want to do something, but they don't know how to write it. So if you can add this to your proposition as a startup, you can have yourself another revenue stream. I think you presented very well, and it's definitely a need everywhere, also in Albania. Well done.
Thank you, Tal. Thank you all.
Next startup is aiming to help their clients in the procurement process. It's Inegosia. Success.
Hello, everyone. My name is Eglon, and I'm representing Inegosia, which is aiming to transform procurement in Albania and beyond. So 8 years ago, during my studies on international public procurement, I started to think, how do private companies perform their purchases for the services and needs, that what they need? So we found out that most companies, especially in Albania, do not perform good procurement procedures. So they are having limited number of suppliers, not transparent process, and a very low efficiency. Thus, they are missing best value for money for the purchases they make. So we came up with a solution and develop an innovative platform, and also through our procurement expertise, we'll help our clients to have a wide range of suppliers, more transparency, and also efficiency. So the idea is that the client will send the purchase needs to our team, and we will analyze them on a local or global market possibilities. Then thus, those events will be published on our online platform, and the bidders will compete for the best offer. So, and the best bidder will be sent to the client in order to engage. These are some views of our platform that is being developed. So right now the target market of our company is around 700 million euros in Albania, and we estimate revenues for around 7 to 21 million euros per year on that market. We are the first company to dedicate procurement services to our clients, and there are no other competitors in Albanian market except the traditional procedures that are being used right now on the businesses and international companies that may enter the market in the future. Monetization is based on a transaction fee on the transaction volume that we will generate on the year, and also through a gain share model, that where we divide the cost savings for our clients. Right now we are developing beta version, and also we have contacted first potential clients that are big companies in Albania, and also we are increasing networking through UPLIFT. This year we intend to have a stable platform release, and also our first 5 clients, and next year to reach 10 new clients, and on 2023 we aim to have a 5% on our target market and also start expanding in the region. Our team is founded by me and Dorina and Melinda, and also Gristel, that is tech expert, and we have all background on procurement, law, and also financial and business administration. So let's discuss your procurement needs and start give rise to transform experience with iNegotio. Thank you, everyone.
I can go first if okay. What are you guys in need of the most?
So mostly we need partnerships, strategic partnerships, to develop faster our product, and also to have our first clients engage with us so we can start this journey.
Document quality assurance is one of the things that stops big corporations doing business with the small companies. And I speak on this from experience. What sort of market are you planning to tackle, small, medium, or large enterprises?
So it will be mostly medium and large enterprises. Because then for those enterprises, we could generate more value and it's more feasible for us and the client to engage.
If I can suggest that the medium enterprises would be best to look for, because the large enterprises already have have their own systems on procurement and quality assurance, it'd be very hard to tackle in. But what you need to uplift, it's basically the medium enterprise, which needs to go into an interaction with the large corporations, but they have to be at the quality assurance that the large corporations need from the small enterprises in Albania.
At least in the Albanian market, also large corporations do not use the proper tools for procurement process. So many large companies are still using emails and other sort of communication to do the procurement process. So I think we have space also for the large corporations.
I want to say something, and Andre touched it on the previous startup as well. The fact that you guys show huge potential, my market is 700 million, 2 billion, 3 trillion, doesn't really impress when you don't explain how you're going to reach this market, reach your first customer. Now, to ask us to bring the customer, of course, is not relevant. It is your job as a startup to do that. And it is very important to focus, to take a deep breath and understand. It's okay. They will fix it. How to reach your first customer. This is so important for you as a startup to understand and to do that. But yes, you presented very well, and I wish you good luck.
Thank you very much.
If I can ask one thing also. So I understand the urge to, you know, get the first clients that are willing to procure their needs through the platform. But what about the supply side? What efforts do you need there? And how do you... So would you need to be active on the client side and also on the supplier side, or how do you?
We will have to be active in both sides, and that's going to be reached mostly by marketing, online marketing, and also sending invitations to all the suppliers in different fields of activities. Thank you.
A big problem in the research and universities in general is plagiarism, and we are very happy that one of our startups is offering a solution for that. So let's welcome Crossplag.
You could see the presentation, right? Okay, cool. So we can go on. Hi, thanks for having me here. I'm Besart. I'm the founder and CEO of Crossplag. I've been working in this industry for more than 5 years, and we have delivered more than 6 different complex projects for this industry. The story begins with academia, which was initially aimed to the Albanian speaking market in terms of solving plagiarism detection. And we focused on the local problems, which is the low academic output. And then we found out that along the way, we found a big problem, and we developed a disruptive, innovative solution. The big problem today in this industry is the translation plagiarism. So what we did is that we developed a digital tool to enable multilingual and cross-lingual similarity detection. How it works is basically we leverage AI technologies to enable the similarity detection without language barriers. So practically, you just have to upload the document, set language parameters, and we will generate a similarity report. In terms of the market, we have 3 different segments. The first one is the PhD candidates. The next one is researchers, and the third one is publishing houses. We aim to cross-check around 1.2 million writings within a 5-year period, through a subscription model for B2B and B2C, but also through white labeling and resellers. In terms of competition, we are the first in translation, second in language coverage, third in source coverage, and second in types of plagiarism. In terms of competitive advantages, we have our own proprietary technologies that allow this. We are the first in the market, and we provide the best value for money, and we also have our proprietary archives. We have been going through the first version in 2018, then we piloted our product in Kosovo and Albania, and then we launched the second version in 2020. Already today, we have more than 500 leads with €0 invested in marketing, and we are aiming to build API plugins and deliver some sales for B2C and B2B market. In terms of investment, we are looking at €100,000 to dedicate just for a sales and marketing team, and also to kind of pay the operations for that in terms of ads and promotion. The whole core team behind this product is me working in product development and a bit of business, Aurel working in architecture and infrastructure, Visar with UX and visuals, and Ibrahim with AI and NLP. We all together have delivered more than 26 projects to 20 clients, and we have been working together for more than 3 years. Thank you.
Let's jump to the questions from the jury.
Yes. I would start if that's okay. So regarding the monetization aspect, you're mentioning subscription model, but is that really suitable because you're targeting the first pool was PhD candidates and researchers? Isn't there better to go pay as you go or something different than a subscription because a PhD candidate doesn't really have that much output to be engaged in a subscription?
So what we actually meant by subscription is something that they could pay, whether in monthly basis or pay as you go, as you said. But going into details for 3 minutes, it was difficult. So practically, we have different models, whether they want to pay for unlimited checking throughout the month, or they want to check based on their number of documents that they need to use during their like PhD writings or the researches that they need for themselves. So definitely in the subscription model, we include different models based on their needs and requirements.
Okay. I'm not sure I understand actually what you do. Can you just simplify this for me? What are you doing?
Yeah. So practically, if let's say in Polish, a student copies from English, practically that would be uncaught. And his teachers would think that he has written an authentic work while he practically just translated content from English and submitted in Polish as authentic.
Good for him. Okay, yep. I get it. So you don't like this so much?
No, I don't.
Okay. So what you do is your algorithm can check it and verify it. Okay, and how many tests have you done so far? You mentioned 6 universities.
No, actually, we have 12 public universities in Albania, and we have 3 private universities in Kosovo that we work with.
So no, you already launched it with them?
Yeah. The technology behind Crossplay is being used by universities in Kosovo and Albania.
I see. Okay, yep. And they're paying also?
Yes, definitely.
What's your income? What's your
just in 2020 we did €100,000, which for us was great, and it was the first deals that we signed was in 2020.
Very nice. And what are you asking for, just to conclude?
Yeah, we are only asking €100,000 just to dedicate a sales and marketing team for the international market and not the local market.
The 100,000 will give you enough air to reach the airport, but nothing more. I think you should go.
Just for 1 year.
I mean, you have people here from the US who will tell you before you have $500,000, don't even think about US. Okay, so.
No, actually, the U.S. is not our target. Are the non-English speaking countries that are our target.
Okay. Thank you. Very nice.
Thank you.
So if we can have another question for 10 seconds, then go for it. Or if all the questions are answered, then I would thank Crossplay.
No, can you just elaborate quickly on the competitive advantages that you have versus the other platforms that universities across EU are already using?
So practically most of the tools in this industry use search engines. and usually use some basic algorithm for similarity detection. What we do, on the other hand, is we crawl and index and process information and store it in our own archives. And we have developed the cross-lingual through machine translation algorithms. So this makes it possible for us to find plagiarism even in documents that have been deleted from the web. So practically, once we have it in our database, they will stick there forever, and not using search engines which could be outdated after 1 year or 2 years.
Thank you very much, and good job. And now, as we are halfway through the pitching, I want to hand over to a wonderful supporter of UPLIFT team and UPLIFT startup, EU from Innovation in Tirana, and hand over to Ms. Jaspert.
Thank you very much,
Hi,
Mary.
Kushtrim wants to say hi, so I'm not.
Okay.
Hello. I was. My intent was just like to ask first you to support you on the stage. How it is going? How do you think it is going?
I'm enjoying it a lot. Actually, I miss having everyone here, but again, I can feel the energy through the screens, and I think it's great.
And actually, I wanted to use this opportunity to give the floor. That's why I came here on the half of the journey. I wanted to introduce, the floor to some two very, very good supporters. And now we are good friends, which is Jacqueline Jaspert, who is from EU for Innovation. I would like a big applause for her support she did in UPLIFT. But of course, to another very important guy, very important person who stayed in our journey in a very trusted way. He's Mr. Jakub Moder. A big applause from Jakub. Thanks to Jacqueline and to Jakub, we had actually a lot of support from international expertise. We were there that we saw a lot of experts that speaks a lot of languages. From Germany to Swiss to Israel to a lot of countries. So that's why I came here to support you first and to give the floor to two very great personalities and then continue with the four startups.
We are very lucky to really have your support. So thank you on UPLIFT Startups behalf, and would love now to hear your remarks.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kushtrim, for the very kind words. But as you know, it's not me as a person, but it's the whole EU for Innovation team and the whole ecosystem and all the stakeholders of the ecosystem that are currently supporting UPLIFT. So I know I'm standing between you and the next exciting pitches, so I'll keep it very brief. I would like to address, first of all, the participating teams, because I think you can be really very proud, because having you today on stage really proves that you are very successful and that you made it until this or to this demo day really, really proves that you have the strength to develop your business further, and that is great. I would also like to encourage you, of course, not only to implement and use the knowledge that you have gained during the UPLIFT program, but also to keep the networks and the linkages that you made during the UPLIFT program active, the connections that you were able to make to the great mentors, to the great, and also to potential investors, because that's a really great added value. Currently, there are things really moving in the Albanian ecosystem, and I think that is great, because you will have also support after the UPLIFT program has ended. So please stay updated and just stay an active member of the startup community in Albania, and also be a proud ambassador of the UPLIFT program and of the UPLIFT, or let's say the bigger community, the Albanian ecosystem. With the second remark, I would also like to address the UPLIFT team. What an excellent job you guys are doing. So it's really amazing. After this very successful first edition of the program, now having, you know, the second edition being even more professional, more targeted, that's really great to see. One can really sense and see the dedication and the hard work that you put in this program. And I really, really wish that this program can continue also with this spirit. And please consider us, EU for Innovation, always as your supporter and partner. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your for innovation. And now we can hand over to Mr. Jacob, if you can still hear us.
Yes, I can. You can hear me fine?
Yes.
All right. So thank you again for the invite. I'll be short and sweet and straight to the point, as I always am. So I represent the Swiss Entrepreneurship Program. We have been around now for over 5 years. I'm responsible for 5 ecosystems in the Balkans. So I can say that Albania has come a long way as an ecosystem, but we are still playing a catch-up game. Don't be of any illusion that the others sitting around doing nothing. It's not the case. There are countries around that are doing very, very well, and they're putting in tremendous amounts of money into the startup ecosystem, both from the public sector and from the private sector. So it's super important that what is happening today is appreciated with UPLIFT Albania. It is the first real proper accelerator in Albania. The fact that it's happening for a second time in 2 years is fantastic. So my hat goes off to Kushtrim and his team, to all the support I got from the Slovak side and my colleagues at the EU side and a little bit of us from the Swiss side. But I really wanted to talk about something else when you give me the chance. And this is that this should be a celebration of the entrepreneurial spirit of the entrepreneurs. Because it's easy to forget what we're doing this for. And we're doing it for the entrepreneurs, the few brave that are up there today presenting their business models and their cases for a better future. But we can do all the help that we want. But unless these entrepreneurs succeed, well, we haven't come very far at all. And let's be honest, this is almost my 30th year in the Balkans, and countries that still struggle with youth unemployment around 30-40% can never claim that they have done a good job. So yes, we are on the right track, but a little bit of reality never hurt anybody. There's a lot of big works yet ahead, and most of it will have to come from the entrepreneurs themselves. This is the time to step up. So if we don't have a startup community where the founders of this great startup start working together, supporting each other, we will never have an entrepreneurial ecosystem. It doesn't matter how great the policies are. It doesn't matter. It is the entrepreneurs that have to drive it. And if that doesn't happen, we will never have a viable economy. And then the young people will continue to leave. So there's much at stake, right? So we need more of uplifts around, right? But we need to treasure and support these few brave entrepreneurs that we have. And that's why an individual like Kushtrim Shala should be recognized for his entrepreneurial spirit, first of all, yeah? And going out of his way to do something more for the community. That's the essence. So if I have an ask for the future, it's for other entrepreneurs, and they're full of them, many of them very successful in Albania. It's their time to step up. They should be the jury members here today. They should be the mentors, and they should become the next generation of angels. You know, without the local ecosystem actors stepping up, you know, I'm very happy to sit here and talk. I can talk all night, but you know, I wish next year that somebody would replace me. You know, some local talent will have to step up, you know, and say, this is the way we're going to drive the ecosystem forward in the future. So time to give back, guys, time to step up. So thank you very much. Good job. Keep in touch.
Thank you very much for the great remarks, and the very straightforward. It's always good to know what we lack in our reality and then work on that. And I think we are in the right track with the help of our friends. So thank you to all of you. Now, I would like to go back to the other startup, Swiping. Good luck.
Hello, everyone. I am Sahar Burici, co-founder of Swiping. We all have bought at least one time online, and we all know that there is a huge difference between shopping online and shopping in the real world. The online shopping experience has become a boring and lonely experience. That's the reason why we started Swiping, to create a fun, interactive, and social shopping experience that brings value into commerce for both shoppers and retailers. Today, there are millions of products online, and we are all becoming overwhelmed by choice, searching and deciding what to buy from sponsored content from brands and from influencer posts. 96% of the people don't trust ads, while 84% of them trust recommendations that come from family and friends. So Swiping is a mobile social shopping app where people can discover products, share recommendations, get advice, and shop with their friends, family, and community around them. Online shopping is booming. After the COVID hit the earth, people are shopping online more than ever, and is expected to reach $6.5 trillion only in 2021. We are focused in the European market, in fashion and beauty industry, which is a $167 billion market. Today, majority of marketplaces are search-based platforms where people know what they want, search for it, buy it, and leave. On the other hand, Swiping is a feed-based format where people will be happy to come and discover what they want. We are disrupting the shopping experience by bringing that real mall effect where people can invite and go shopping with their friends just from their mobile phone, and also a peer-to-peer recommendation system where people can share recommendations and get advice from people that they know and they trust the most. We are charging our retailers a 10 to a 15% commission fee per sale, and also we want to incorporate ads in our app in the future as a content. So far, we have 250 pre-registered users in our app. We have made partnership with 220 brands, and we have already 2 million products in our app. We want to reach 100,000 users, to make partnership with 500 brands, and to generate $2 million sales till the end of 2021. We are a team of 8 people with a business and tech background that came together to build Swiping. Swiping will get bigger and bigger in the future by incorporating mobile wallet with our app and expanding into horizontal markets like booking services, transportations, and peer-to-peer commerce. We are looking for funding in order to grow our team and increase our user base in order to reach our goals. Are you ready to change the way people shop tomorrow?
Question and answers.
You already have 200 brands or partners, but only 250 pre-registered users. So how do you plan on acquiring a large number of users?
We want to collaborate with influencers that are niche in fashion and beauty industry. That's and we want to reach 1,000 users before the launch. We are one month and a half before the launching, and also in marketing. We will use Pinterest, Instagram as the most platforms in marketing.
Can you elaborate more on the on the payment aspect? So how is the payment processing structured, and the currency in which the products are shown on our mobile, since you're targeting international brands and international end users? So
yeah, so we are collaborating so far with 3 affiliate agencies. So the payment will be through affiliate users. When we click, they will be redirected to the retailer's website, and they will buy. For currencies, we in the beginning will support only 2 currencies, dollars and euros. But soon, very soon after the launch, we will support all the currencies, and we will surface that to the users, the currency on that country that they are.
It seems like a very interactive platform, and apparently from what I can see from your presentation, the users have to use time online. What target age are you planning to tackle here?
So we are targeting millennials and Generation Z from 16 to 35 years old, but in the beginning we'll target mostly that Generation Z, because they are more likely to embrace new technologies and new apps that are in that surface to their van.
I would say you took yourself a very big challenge here. We all have endless number of apps on our phones. Problem is the engagement. So I do think you have done here a lot of work. You sound very fluent, very good. You almost persuaded me to use your app. But I think the big challenge would be really to do the engagement. What is this secret sauce that your app will have to stick, to glue people to you?
So in the core of our app we will use a gamification technology technique through rewards. We will reward our users for every action that they do in our app, and as a reward in the end they will get exclusive discounts, exclusive coupons to shop in the for products. So we'll encourage them to share, to shop with their friends, to share recommendations, to invite their friends and shop with them, and to browse, to discover, to save products, to create bags.
So I think you touched it. I think AI here is definitely something that you should speak about more. And by the way, so many accelerators now in Europe open on the cluster of AI. And just last thing, you mentioned that you want funding, and I understand that you leave it to us to decide how much. You don't want to share it with us.
If you are interested, we can talk later.
I think the problem is that he has no more time to share it right now.
Well, I'm told I have 3,000 euros to spend, so I'm just telling you. Okay.
Thank you. And very good job.
Good luck. You've done well.
Now, the last two startups, the last three actually, are a little bit in different time zones, because one of them, we have it in Canada. Our mayor mentioned at the beginning a success story, Airbnb, but we have Albanian here at Uplift, which we are hoping to grow as big. Why not? So from Canada, Albanian to pitch.
Can you guys hear me? Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
Awesome. Hi, everyone. Sorry, I couldn't be there in person. I'm kind of stuck in Canada with the whole COVID situation right now, but I'm going to try to do my best from here. So my name is Sami Muli. I'm the founder of Albanb.com, which is an Albanian property management and vacation rental booking platform that allows people to monetize their space or tour guides for a set listing fee. We're on a mission to better the experience of both locals spending their holidays in Albania and also foreign travelers visiting Albania. We want to make Albania the must place to visit in Europe and make Albanian tourism a premium experience. Currently, both tourists and hosts come across challenges with existing platforms like Airbnb and Booking, such as language barriers, because a lot of our Albanian elderly hosts don't speak English. Hosts have technical challenges with properly managing their listings, and there's no local on-site support, and there's also payment processing issues due to a lower digital banking adoption in Albania and no offline payment options from some of the platforms. And also these platforms charge higher and variable commission fees that vary on seasonality. That's where Airbnb comes in as the first major local player, filling these gaps, making sure the listings or places are properly set up by offering local support, training to hosts to better serve their guests by offering direct and offline payment methods and charging obviously a lower amount of fees. Apart from the lower amount of fees compared to competition, the intent of the platform is to be used during off-peak summer season, during spring, fall, and winter by locals wanting to get away for a day or a weekend in a different city or mountain, or go for a hike or find a restaurant. There's also opportunities and potential for short-term hourly rentals that other platforms don't currently offer, and also promotional content monetization. Albania has a very small population, and its tourism has doubled its population basically. Albania's tourism is still fairly low, with a contribution of only 363 million or 3% of GDP, compared to Croatia, whose contribution to GDP is 25% or over $10 billion. Competition charges different amount of fees. And as you can see, our fees are set and are lower than any of the competition, and which is easier for guests to kind of plan their revenues and expenses. We want to be the most affordable and accessible platform in Albania. We've built and launched our web platform, and we're going to launch soon after the Accelerator program. And we plan to start into the campaign and earn over 1,000 hosts by the end of the summer. And we plan on switching on growth.
Thank you, Sami. This was just 3 minutes for the pitch. And now let's jump to the questions from the jury.
Hey, Sami, can you talk a little bit about just go-to-market strategy and how you're going to, you know, one, bring the users on board, and two, from a host perspective, but then the people that, you know, are going to book through there, knowing that like a platform like Airbnb has, you know, all the traffic that it gets now. And I know personally, I've used Airbnb in Albania and so. Can't hear you, you're on mute.
You're mute.
Sami, we can't hear you. Just
can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. So currently, we're already taking hosts that are registering their properties on Airbnb. We've launched an email marketing campaign. We've scraped all the users or the hosts that are using Airbnb and Booking.com. We're reaching out to them directly to list their properties on Airbnb. So we're going to use that technique to actually gain the hosts, and we plan on doing a social media marketing campaign to gain through different local partners and influencers to gain the market, which is predominantly Albanian diaspora from Kosovo and Albania that spend most of the holidays in Albania. And this is the kind of the direction we're going on tackling different partners, whether it's social media marketing, Dua, which is a matchmaking platform, and different partners to gain traction on gaining also guests as opposed to just hosts as well into the platform. And also using different channels that we have at the tourism, the Ministry of Tourism on trying to use their sites or the info tourism sites to promote our services and be that one-stop shop and content management for tourism in Albania and promote it not just in Albania, but also overseas as well.
We are in the last minute of the questions.
So do you plan to have online payments for the tourists, or is it going to be cash on hand when they come to the venue? And what protection have you thought of, you know, giving the tourists in terms of cancellations and payment difficulties and similar?
So there's going to be both offline and online payment options. There's only a limited amount of online payment options in Albania, but we'll tackle all the ones that currently exist in Albania through different local banks. In terms of cancellations and stuff, we are going to try to manage or set the expectation that the cancellations by the host don't happen. And if cancellation by the guest happen, there's going to be a notification method ahead of game to let the host know that the cancellation happened. But it's hard to manage that piece without having a set policy in place.
Thank you, Sami.
Thank you.
This was your moment. Very good job. And now Thank you. Last two startups are focused on healthy lifestyle. And the next one who is going to pitch now is making gym's life much easier with their platform, Wellness Plus.
Hi, everybody. My name is Erdian. I am here to present you Wellness Plus, the easier way for gyms to make their customers happy and loyal. Currently, there are more than 300,000 gyms all over the world. There are more than 3 million personal trainers and over 200 million members. And the number is growing, but the landscape is terrible. As a gym member myself, I see that client assistance is very poor. Targeted marketing is basically non-existent. Finding them is mostly done by reference. I barely see a difference from the previous gym I went to, and when I leave, they don't even notice. I see that gyms have a great need to have full control of their workflow, but they can't do that. Why? Because they don't have the right tools. At best, they have gym CRMs, which helps them with membership. And the rest is general purpose technology, which doesn't talk with each other. Like, for example, access control, the communication, the marketing, assistance, so on and so forth. But we have developed a solution. We have an all-in-one platform, which can be set up in just 1 hour, and it will help these gyms handle issues like access control, build them an engaging website, guide their users through their journey, assign them diets, help them build their training program, get data on the business and the user's activity so you can improve their services and also their marketing communication based on user preferences. Make users part of the community, make them part of your gym workflow, and make them loyal. Our business model is simple. We target gyms and personal trainers. They pay a monthly fee, and we also gain a margin from the sales of access control devices. We also are working on a B2C model. The competition is basically general purpose technology or gym CRMs that doesn't do much more than that. We are the only ones who cover not only the management, but we also cover social impact and also community growth. We currently have 10 clients. We have made an experiment, and our experiment, out of 100 people we have contacted, 15 become leads and 5 customers. During the COVID time, we lost only 2 customers, which shows that even in hard times, our clients still find value into our product. My name is Rediana. I'm a software developer. I have a 5 years experience in developing community building and all-in-one technologies. And our goal is to hire more developers and expand to Kosovo and across the Balkans. We are looking for strategic partners or investors. Please come talk to me. Thank you.
A great presentation. It's just that I have to point out that many of you benchmark against the global market. I think that every new business idea should find a solution for an existing problem, starting from at least the small Albanian market. How did this idea come up? How did you come up with this idea? What was the problem that you're trying to solve with gym memberships in the country?
Well, the idea came up from my experience as a gym member. So I started talking with gyms. I started seeing and experiencing, but also talking to gyms. And my product currently focused on small to medium gyms in order to make them compete with the big gyms who have their own system. So gyms need to innovate if they need to survive. And this is why the idea came up from.
We have 2 more minutes for other questions.
Well, I just Googled and I see a very large number of other software, at least what they say is like gym management. Can you really touch the competitive advantage that you have?
Yes. There are different services that help gyms manage their facilities. The best part of them do membership management and access control. But the rest, the services that there are on the market, they do not include customers to be part of the gym. So if a member goes to a gym, it needs to have an app for it to track the progress, another app for it to have the schedule of the workouts, and probably to follow the gym on Instagram in order to get feedback from the gym. So what we do is our competitive advantage is we bring all of this together in one single platform. So users just need one platform, one app, and that's all.
I want to offer you an idea. If you were to signal the gym owners about subscriptions that are about to fall out, to drop out, that will be very helpful for them.
This is the minimum that we do.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well done.
Thank you.
If we can have another question in 20 seconds, or is everything clear for the jury?
I don't know, can you go back to that slide where you spoke about the monetization model? So you're charging subscriptions, and there was another thing, but I didn't get it quite right. So you charge them a monthly subscription, a monthly fee?
They pay a monthly fee, and we also gain a margin from the sales of access control devices. So we sell them access control devices, and like they would want the access control system, they would want cards, branded cards, bracelets, and so on. So we can give them and gain a margin from them. And we currently have clients that we all already sell and generate revenue from that.
Thank you, and great job, Wellness. And now the last startup to pitch is focusing in giving healthy meals, so NutriPrep.
Hello everyone, my name is Sherim Sarmojai and I'm in love with sports. Just like any other, I have experienced my ups and downs during my sports career, but one thing that I have noticed is that if you want to get the best out of yourselves, you need to be eating right. You want to wake up a better version of yourselves every single day, and our mission at NutriPrep is to help you achieve that. But problems like not having enough time to prepare your food, being under or overweight, and lack of knowledge regarding nutrition, and also unhealthy eating lead to an unpleasant way of life. What we offer as a solution to that is ready-made meals, customizable meal plans, and highly nutritious products. You can access our products and services by joining us on our website and also automatically generate your meal plans there. Our target market contains of three target groups: people that work out, people that need to either gain or lose weight, and also people that work in offices. The target group is around 25,000, and we have created a community which has over 500 people that are interested in eating healthy. During the last month, we have done product testing, and we have had a very successful story. Taulan Goshi has lost 4 kilograms using our products in the last month. We position ourselves as a very practical company with medium prices in comparison to other competitors. And you can buy our products as product unit, weekly plan, and monthly plans. The sale will be done in gyms, shops, and by delivery. And our team consists of 5 members. 4 of us are students, specialized in economy, sports education, product design, and also food science. And 1 of us is a personal trainer who will act as a promoter for our company. We are supported by Venture UP, during which we have been through an incubator program in there. We have been funded for 3,000 euros by them, and UPLIFT ALBANIA, during which we could develop our software, develop our website, and we also did product testing. Our objectives for 2021 are to join the market, close at least 1 B2B deal with another company to sell our products to them, expand the sales channels, have 4 employees, and also reach 50,000 euros in sales. Why do we need funding? We need funding because we want to invest on equipment for our kitchen, and we want to invest in promotion. We need around 20,000 euros for these 2 things. If you have any question, you can contact us by email or phone number. Eat better with NutriPrep.
Let's jump to the questions from the jury.
So you basically said that you're targeting about 25,000 people, but from the way you describe, I say it's pretty much everyone who wants to eat healthy and better. Regardless, you're setting yourself up to a lot of competition. This is one of the startups or is sort of a business model that has started in Albania, at least, and it's going very well in the last 10 years. And I personally am one of the customers, or used to be one of the customers, and I've tried pretty much whatever's in the market. They all have the same price baseline. Good quality food. What would be your monthly or weekly price?
the prices of the products will range from 2.3 and up to 4 euros. And the prices of the meal plans will be an accumulated price of all the products that are in a plan. Also, what separates us from others is that we also have a software which generates meal plans automatically, and we can use that as a revenue stream for our business.
And have you tried to monetize your meal planning software already? Or maybe you mentioned it, but I didn't hear it. Do you have some paying customers right now? And if not, is there any way you could charge or sell something even with?
We're having bad connection, I think. But can I answer the first question?
I think we lost your connection, Andre. Can you please repeat the question?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah, so the first question was if you already sold some of your meal planning software to someone. And if you already have some paying customers, or do you need, or you are seeking the investment to start a business and to buy the needed equipment?
At the moment, we have only done product testing. We haven't sold any product because of the conditions we are in. We need more investment for the kitchen. And also about the first question, we haven't sold our meal plans separately yet, because in the meal plan generator, there are only meals of that we produce integrated in that system, in that software. So we need to expand the software a little bit more, and then we could sell it as just a meal plan generator. But we are first trying to use it this way and test it this way, and then in later stages of our business, we will try to expand that way too.
Well done for successfully ending this pitching for today. So first, I would like to congratulate all of you startup teams. You rocked the stage, and I'm sure that you were really surprising for everyone. You were on your top. So I really hope that today you will enjoy this as a great memory, as and a great start to your growing journey as a business. And now I would kindly ask the jury to move to a closed meeting for the final decision. You should have received a link on the chat. And please move on that new Zoom meeting for the closed final decision on the winners. And then we're going to come back in this main room for the final decision. And for everyone else, I have the great pleasure to have the representative of the great relationship between Albania and Slovakia, the Slovakian ambassador in Tirana, Mr. Peter Spisiak. I think we cannot hear you. We cannot yet hear. Can we please check maybe if we have the problem with audio? I think, please, can you check the audio on your computer? We cannot yet hear you, and seems like everything is okay on our side. You can try changing the mic that you're using. Probably there's an issue there. Mosesh mute. Okay. Apologizes for everyone who is still here with us. We're just having these technical issues that happen when we're live streaming. But the good thing is that, as I mentioned at the beginning, you feel like you're in here with us together. So we're going to fix this quite soon. Okay, so while we're waiting for the ambassador to fix this issue, I'm very happy for all of you. It's fixed. Hello, can... Now we can hear you. I think now it's okay. Can you... sorry, seems like we lost the audio again. Okay, we are so sorry for this because we were really looking forward to Mr. Ambassador's remarks, but we can jump later on that. After we fix this technical issue. And now for everyone, we have the pleasure to have an international expert as keynote speaker on strategy and transformation. So I will now hand over to Mr. Christian Rangan for his speech.
Thank you and good afternoon, Albania. Can you guys hear and see me okay?
Yes, we can hear and see you very well. Thank you for joining us.
No, thank you. So I was just in Canada working with a long line of startups, and it's really a pleasure to get the invitation to join you guys. So I'm going to talk about scale-ups. I'm going to talk about investor readiness. And you know, just to check, you guys can see my slides?
Not yet.
All right, that's very good. I'm glad we checked. Let's see.
Okay, now it's okay. Yeah. I think we just need it in the big screen as well for everyone here. So it's okay. We are ready to hear and very looking forward to your speech.
Fantastic. So thank you again for the invitation. So I'm joining you from Norway. I have about 20 years experience working with startups and scale-ups and investors. I do a lot of work with governments and ecosystems and accelerators, but really what I do is I help founders and investors to grow, scale, and create value. And I was just listening to the last presentation. I really love the energy. I love the idea. And I would love to see how are you going to take that idea and turn it into money? Because what is that roadmap that leads to a successful business? And what is that roadmap that leads to a successful business for your investors? It's a key question. So I'm going to be speaking about raising money. I'm going to talk about how to get investor ready. And of course, if you're interested, please connect on LinkedIn, connect on Twitter, and you can find me on pretty much every social media channel. And what I'm going to be talking about today is taken from a extensive program that I teach called Scale Up Coach Global Program. And here we really dig into what does it take to raise successful financing? How do you grow and scale your company? And how do you go from idea to an IPO and a public listing? But I'm going to share a couple of stories with you. And the first story I want to share is a company called Mirror. Some of you may have heard of it. Some of you may have bought it. Some of you may have bought it for your girlfriends or boyfriends. I don't know. But Mirror was started a couple of years ago in the US. And it's being told as a superstar founder and a superstar return. And I would really wish for all of you guys watching this presentation right now that you could become superstar founders with superpowers and also create superstar returns. I'm going to tell you what that means. So this is the story of how a former ballerina, you know, the ballet dancer, started the company and turned it into a 300 million and then later a 500 million success in just a couple of years. It's a fantastic story and she deserves a lot of credit. So she started Mirror and she built it, and then sold it to Lululemon, the fitness company, for 500 million US cash. Boom. That's worth a couple of years of work. Now, for those of you that are paying attention to this space, you have Peloton, which is the high-tech bike, and you have Mirror, which is the high-tech mirror. And they are both competing in the space for healthy lifestyles and digital services. So I'm going to talk you through the funding story and the background of how Bright here started and built that company. So the funding story is what I spend a lot of time working on, because we realized that a lot of startups, they don't have a funding story. They have a product story. They will talk to you about the product. We are going to launch a social media app. We're going to launch a healthy food service. We're going to launch products, but we need to talk about the money, my friends. So in the example of Mirror, they raised their first seed financing. And of course, it's being US, it's much, much bigger amounts. So they raised their first seed financing in 2016 at a valuation of somewhere between 20 and 40 million US. 2.8 million from one small VC firm. And of course, as you can probably see here, we have founders' cash and credit cards, and that's how most founders start their companies. We have friends and family, you're going to your parents and your brother and your grandma, personal network, crowdfunding, business angels, accelerators, family offices, typically for bigger rounds, corporate venture capital, small VC, and big VC firms. So she raised 2.8 million from first round. And then less than 2 years later, she raises 13 million from some of the leading VC firms in East Coast US. And now all of a sudden she has five significant important VCs for raising her A series, where she raised 13 million at a 50 to 150 million valuation, 2 years. Then just a few months later, 200 million pre-launch valuation. So this is something she does before she even has a product. There is no product yet. There is no customers and there is no revenue. 200 million pre-launch launch valuation, which is amazing. Now she raises 25 million US from a single VC firm for her B series at a 200 million valuation. And she keeps going and she keeps going. Now, next, she raises 25 million at a 300 million valuation in a B plus from large investors and three business angels. Angels are sitting right here. And then she sells the company to Lululemon. And reading the press release is a fantastic story because it really talks about the strategic rationale of why did we choose to buy Mirror. Now, we're going to dig into the numbers a little bit. So this company was founded in 2016. It launched to the market in 2018. And 2 years later, they sell the company for 500 million US. 140 employees. Now, what I like down here is she raised about 75 million US, which is a lot of money. And she exited for 500 million. In doing so, she created 370 million for her investors. And she personally created 130 million for herself. Now, this is what we need to develop more of in Europe, whether you're in Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Germany, UK, or in Albania. We need to develop these funding stories. So we're building founders and building companies that are really, really good at the technology, but also at the product and also at the funding side. It is what we call getting investor ready. We're going to dig a little bit deeper into this story and see how she actually did it. Because it's being called a modern day fairy tale story. Having a female entrepreneur come in and raise 75 million US and then she cashes out 130 million while also creating a significant return for her investor. Everybody wins. So how do you go about doing that? And what are the steps and the thinking you need to go through? This is what we call the valuation method. Like, what are the valuation methods that you should apply in your company? And we typically work with 8 different valuation methods. And I think many of you guys already know and probably quite familiar with some of these. So you have valuation methods like, what is your historical cash flow? How much money did you make last year? What is your budget? How much money are you going to make this year? How much money do you need for the next year and a half, 2 years? How much money do you need versus what are you willing to give up? How big is the market opportunity? What are other companies doing? What is the exit potential? And then finally, what is the strategic pricing and the strategic value? They are incredibly different valuation methods. Now, I've been teaching entrepreneurship. I've been teaching finance. And you have to understand as an entrepreneur, which of these should you apply in your case? So going back to our friends at Mirror. So what you see here is some interesting information around the pandemic. And I'll walk you through some of the case for which valuation method did they apply when they sold Lululemon. So if we take the first one, you can see here, and I don't know how many of you have a business and finance background, but you can see that the company was sold for 11x last year's revenue, which is a very, very high number. Usually companies, at least in this part of the world, sells for between 1 and 3x revenue, maybe 5x revenue. So it's a very, very high number. But you look at the budget forecast, the company only sold for 5 to 3x revenue, which is not very expensive at all. So based on the revenue forecast, it's a very, very good deal for the buyer. But of course, a much bigger trend, COVID. So Lululemon didn't have a business that could stand in the face of COVID. So they needed to find some kind of digital business where they can expand on. So the COVID situation was actually a big driver of why they got that good valuation. Comparable cases. So the biggest competitor to Mirror is Peloton. And Peloton has a 4 billion valuation and they're aiming for 100 million users. So naturally, Mirror looks at the same thing and say, we can achieve that as well. And we are very cheap comparatively. But finally, and this is the big thing for you guys as founders to understand. Digital strategy on the buyer side. So if a company is looking to buy you, you need to understand where do you fit into their strategy. So in this case, Lululemon had something they called the power of three, where they said, we're going to double our efforts in digital, even if we have to go buy them. But the big reason, and this is probably no surprise to you guys, the big reason was Nike, because the buyer was terrified of what would happen if Nike keeps buying and buying and buying all the good companies. So, wow, we need to buy this company before Nike gets it. So those are 5 different valuation methods. And as you probably can see, there are very different logic behind them. There's very different reasoning. And you guys as founders, when you're building successful companies, you need to understand when you're raising your seed round and your angel and A, B, and C, which valuation methods should you apply in your work with investors? And that's why we have these 8 startup valuation methods. And you can read more about this case. There's a wonderful, wonderful interview with her where she talks about how she, as a female founder, built this company and really understood, she really understands this value creation part. And, you know, I believe that in my work with startups, you have to understand this if you're going to raise money successfully and build your company. So I'm going to show you the next part, which is the last thing we have in 5 minutes left. This is what we call value creation. Now, not a lot of founders understand this, But the moment you start thinking about investor money, you have also committed yourself to investor value creation. And that is really the outcome of you doing good work. So if you make good strategic decisions and you execute, the outcome is realizing or unlocking value, typically on the equity or scale-up side. I'll show you what that looks like. This is what a happy investor looks like. This is one of the super angels that we have here in Norway. He invests in 60 startups so far. Every single month, he invests in one new startup every year. And he recently invested 40,000 euro and he got 2.8 million euro back. So the company asked him for 40,000 and he got 2.8 million back. That is what we call a 70x return. And that is what makes for a happy investor, happy founders, and happy parties afterwards. And of course, this can happen in different ways. It happens in sales of the company. It happens in IPO or public listing of the company. Or it happens in partial sale and partial liquidity events. And again, if you're going to raise money and if you want to grow your company, you have to really understand this and be comfortable with these elements. So to me, in my work, I say that for you to be investor ready, you have to understand the funding strategy and the funding story, and you have to understand the value creation as a part of your scale-up strategy. How do you create value for your stakeholders, your users, your customers, your team, your employees, and also your investors? So as I'm wrapping up, it really comes down to this. Even at this stage, so when you guys are pitching here in this competition, you should already be planning your exit. And none of the founders that I meet have really started talking about it. You should plan for if and when we get successful financing, how do we give that money back? What are the exits that we are planning for our investors? So some of the things that I do, and you can find this on the website, is I develop a lot of visual strategy tools for founders and scale-ups and investors, government agencies and accelerators to help them build the funding story, help them build the valuation, and then finally also help build the exit so everyone is happy. So my final slide and also invitation for you guys, if you want to learn more, we have a program that's starting in about 2 weeks, 2 weeks time, which basically teaches this with a strong focus on how do we raise money, how do we get investors, and how do we create value and return money back to our investors. So I'm going to leave this. This is my last slide, that when I got the invitation to join you and speak here, I said, why don't we extend an invitation? If any of you want to learn more, you can have a look at their website. And my goal working all over the world and doing a lot of work in Europe is really, how do we build better startups, better scale up that can create value both for the founders and also for the investors? And I think if we can keep doing that, everybody wins, the ecosystem grows, and events like this become just more and more and more popular. So that's my closing. I wish you all the best with a exciting competition you have. I know that the judges are out on the discussing. I wish you all the best with your startup journey. And then eventually I wish you all the best with scaling and growing your companies. Thank you for listening. And I don't know if the organizers want to do any quick questions before we give it back to our other speaker. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your speech. It of course made this exciting waiting time very pleasant for all of us. And now I'm very happy to also have our connection with the Slovakian ambassador. So let me hand over the word to Mr. Peter Spisiak.
Good evening. Can you hear me now?
Good evening. We can finally hear very well.
Okay, because I switched to my phone. So there was probably some problem with my notebook. I'm really very sorry and I apologize for that. But Anyway, dear ladies and gentlemen, dear participants of this hybrid meeting, I feel very privileged to be here today virtually, and I would like to thank you for giving me the opportunity to congratulate the winners of this project. I asked Mr. Straka 5 days ago who would win, and he told me that he didn't know. I must admit he was more discreet and more diplomatic than I should have been. However, I think that all participants are winners. As you are aware, Slovakia is the main donor of this project. Western Balkan region is a traditional partner of the Slovak Development Cooperation, and it features among our priority regions. Slovak aid usually supports the traditional forms of assistance focused mainly on the people in need. But UPLIFT is another type of project, and it is focused on people of desire, those people who want to make a change and push their country forward. And to do so, they need partners. As an ambassador of the Slovak Republic, I'm pleased to say that UPLIFT project has fulfilled this and brought together many partners. Using this opportunity, I would like to reiterate that Slovakia pays particular attention to supporting Western Balkan countries. Western Balkan region has always played a key role in shaping the European stability and security. Slovakia provides political and project-oriented assistance to the region in order to support its European ambitions and thus to contribute to strengthening of local civil society business and to boost young entrepreneurs and startups. And UPLIFT is an excellent way how to demonstrate it. Empowering Albanian and Kosovar innovative entrepreneurs can combat the ever-present brain drain and inspire young people to fulfill their ideas and dreams and improve life in their home countries. This project is a great contribution to educating Albanian and Kosovar mentors on how to help startups navigating in the waters of early stage of business. Let me emphasize that the accession negotiations are very effective instrument to pursue necessary reforms. So there is absolutely no reason to weaken transformative power of the enlargement process. And today it needs to be maintained as a strategic investment in Europe's peace, security, and prosperity even more. Cooperation between SOVA and ICTS media corresponds with Slovak as well as Albanian priorities. I'm sure that every one of you will successfully progress in your future endeavors and thus contribute to the common well-being in your respective community, as well as to Europe's diversity and its multicultural nature, which are integral parts of social structure and an essential and unique cultural asset. Slovakia commends Albanians' constructive engagement in regional cooperation and its dialogue with neighboring countries to ensure good neighborly relations. Thank you for your attention and stay healthy.
Thank you very much. I think this was the right closing to this big day. I hope you all enjoyed. And as I'm waiting for the team to join me, because the big moment came and we're gonna announce the winners of UPLIFT second edition.
A big applause for you guys. Woo! Thank you so much. Thank you, the jury. We came to the end, but of course, without the sponsors, can you please set the screen of the sponsors of UPLIFT? It is very important. We want sponsors because it is their moment.
Here they are.
So, thank you very much, Slovak Aid, for the great efforts and the great trust they have in us. Vodafone Business, Raiffeisen Bank, Altvision. Of course, without EU for Innovation and Swiss CP, it wasn't possible to have this quality. The municipality of Tirana that support us in any step, of course, by offering a great venue such as this we are all together. ICTS Lab, all of my team, ICTS Lab, I would like to invite you, come here, Exxon, Dori, Rhea, Esmeralda. Come here, please. We need to have a picture. Ardi. Ardi have the prizes in their hand, but we want to have a memory in this moment. Please come faster, please. So thank you very much for the hard job you did. I know sometimes we were tough, so we need the memory to have. You done? Thank you. Thank you so much. I forgot to mention also Huawei, who helped us along the way we did with startups. We did a competition and they gave us some nice presents.
A very nice mini demo day actually during Uplift Journey. So thank you for Huawei for offering those very nice prizes to the mini winners of the day. But now, should we jump to the big winners, Kushtrim?
Of course. And Ernst & Young, PC World Chief Information Officer, Scan TV, and Geek Room, of course, for their media support. So, as we know, along this journey, some startups had some milestones. We need to mention Hermex that did a great achievement with Elevator Lab. They were selected as the best startup, competing with many startups around the region. So congratulations. We need to also to mention, yeah. it is very important to mention some other milestones, such as if I remember correctly, it was swiping. It was Wellness Plus, and it was also another one which I don't remember. That one,
which was Old, I think, who is super quiet right now, and super modest.
No, I was meaning about the prize that they win at the EU for Innovation exchange trip. Matchmaking.
Seems like there have been trip. So many prizes that were.
So they did so many milestones along this journey. So yeah. Now let's come to this very bright moment. We need to announce an interesting prize, which is sponsored by Slovak Aid. It is an investable readiness package. But what does this mean? Investable readiness packages, it costs around 10,000 euros in cost for any startup that would like to go into a very deep review in order to make the startup ready to pitch, and of course, ready in terms of reviews, of documents, of the prototypes, of projection plans. So everything the startup will need, it is going to be there. So who is the winner of this prize?
I think Ardi knows.
Can we have some music? Is it possible? Of course. We would like to have some music because it's we are going to celebrate this moment now. And we are going to announce this prize. There is another prize. And then we are going to announce the third, the second, and the first place. So are you ready? No, not yet? Okay, we can do it without music. So the startup and the founder who did very great during this journey and who is going to win the investable readiness package implemented by Sova with the great support of Civita, it is going to be Cross Flag! Woo! Anything to say?
No, just I had a very early in the morning meeting with the Civita team, and it was really nice to kind of discuss with them today, 8:30 in the morning. So I thank them for this evaluation, and it would be truly amazing for us, and we are looking forward to it. So thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Please stay here while we can wait another winners to come, and we can have a joint picture. So the next prize, it is going to be for a very interesting project that we did start last year with our great friends at Sova, and we called it Bridge to You. But what does this mean? We want to make a bridge between Albania and Europe. It's not that we cannot access Europe. We have airplanes and we can go there easily, of course, after COVID. But the problem is that in order to access the high level or the elite level, the elite level of the representative of the ecosystem in Europe, such as Czech Republic, such as Slovakia, such as Austria, of course, it needed some coordination. So Slovak Aid sponsored this prize by building a very tailored project where eight startups actually are going to be part of a very interesting journey. It will be a boot camp where many startups may apply, but only eight of them can go to this, can join this trip. But what we are going to do right now, we are going to give a fast track for Bridge to EU, which means that the one who is going to announce now, it is going to be the one who have the fast track prize for the Bridge to EU. And this one is fourth one. Yeah. Let me check. We have the fourth one. I would like to invite the jury to remember me which was the fourth one, and probably to announce the winner, because it was very, very much overloaded event and I forgot my papers in the meeting. Ah, yes, we have it. So before giving the floor to the jury for the three prizes, I'm going to announce it. The winner of the Fast Track prize for Bridge to EU is Swiping! Woo!
Floor is yours. Thank you very much. Thank you very much to Kushtrim that made us part of this journey. It was a great experience for we as a started as a small founders, and we are now being a big founders. Thank you very much.
Andy, do you want to say something? Yeah, it's the same for me. It's a real pleasure, and we certainly didn't accept this, but we worked hard for this, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
So I'm going to have the prize for the third one, for the third startup, so it's going to be announced tonight. Until now, we had one winner from... I need music, please. We need some celebration. The third one, the one was from Kosovo and one is from Albania. But of course, Kosovo surprises us everywhere when we do events, such as ICT Awards, and even now, they surprise us. It is a startup that did great presentation and great journey tonight. Ul! Ul, it is going to win a prize of 1,000 euro. So congratulations, and this floor is yours.
Thank you very much. This means a lot for us, because if nothing, this will motivate us to continue forward and also continue to develop our startup as much as we can. And I will also like to take a moment to congratulate every startup that was part of UPLIFT. I was truly amazed with the progress of everyone, and I also enjoyed the pitches of everyone here.
Thank you very much. I want to thank UPLIFT especially. It has been a great journey, and working with you, it has been our pleasure. So thank you very much.
Thank you guys. These are some symbolic prizes, right?
We're going to the next two big ones.
Yeah, exactly.
And I think they are super excited to wait anymore, Kushtrim.
Yeah, you are right. So can we go to Albania this time?
Of course, okay. And actually, I don't like to do this separation between Kosovo and Albania because there is none, but let's go to Albania again. Yeah.
And I need to stress out an important thing that happens during the meeting with the jury. They fight about you. I'm very sincere about this. So they fight and they had a very tough discussion. I was never experiencing this kind of evaluation. It was so difficult. But at the end, of course, we had to go faster and announce the winner. So I'm going to announce the next winner, who, of course, you know now that it's from Albania. Why is this desperate music? The second place of UPLIFT Albania 2020-21 is...
Hermax.
Thank you so much. We didn't expect it. Thank you, the jury that fought it for us. Thank you, Kushtrim. This journey has been amazing for us. We met awesome people. We learned a lot, and this is just the start for us. Thank you to my team also that has evolved and helped me a lot during this journey. Thank you so much to all of you.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, thank UPLIFT for this opportunity. This when we entered the we went with a small startup, but now with the help of us of UPLIFT, we are in another mindset. So thank you very much for everything.
Thank you so much. Before announcing the winner, actually, I just wanted to give the floor to the jury because it's always some moments that you can feel you can like. You would like to give something to the whole team in order to recognize how hard they work to this accelerator. So I would like a help from the jury to say some few words, probably Tal, but very short, please, just to say a few words. So what are the expectations? And probably Eddie did some very good remarks during the meeting. He can say something about you guys that, you didn't hear your name, but this doesn't mean nothing. The journey starts tonight.
So first of all, it was really an amazing event and you all did very well. As Kushtrim said, it was not an easy decision to take and we did not have all night. But well, in the end, we have chosen. I think, first of all, you should all be very proud of yourselves. I'm saying this after, I don't know, hundreds of demo days I participated in as a jury. And 60 cohorts of mine that go through demo days. It was really first class with the preparation. Kushtrim, you handled it very well. I'm sorry, I don't remember the name of the beautiful moderator, but you were amazing and you kept us all very, very,
very
engaged.
Much.
Thank you so much. All the team, you have done a great job. You should be very proud of yourself. I'm already feeling proud knowing you, and I know you're gonna go places. You have the right genes. You have the right talk, you dress well, you speak amazing English. Well done to you all. And this is behalf of me, I hope also on behalf of the rest of the jury. Thank you so much. Well done.
Thank you. Eddie.
I mean, I think Tal kind of covered it really, really well. So second, everything he said, you know, from my perspective as somebody that was born there and you know, had an opportunity to leave Kosovo, but you know, come back to Albania, Kosovo all the time. It's impressive. I come out there quite a bit. Jakob and the Swiss EP team, you know, they have me out there quite a bit over the last, you know, five plus years to see the kind of the you know how much better we're doing as an ecosystem is incredible. I do agree with Jakob's, you know, earlier comments that. And we have a long way to go, but that's, to me, that's the exciting part. And, you know, people like yourself, Kushtrim, and I also don't remember the moderator's name, but I do agree that she was
She was incredible, as was the rest of your team throughout this process. So congrats to really everybody that was a part of this. Just remember that, you know, you had to be chosen to be a part of this, regardless of the money or not. And, you know, you have to pick a few winners, but it doesn't mean that, you know, the journey stops, as I think multiple people said earlier. So me personally, I'm very excited and I'm looking forward to hopefully coming out there soon and really being a part of more startups in the region.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Eddie. If no one wants to speak from the jury, anyone wants to speak from the jury before we announce the winner? So yeah, we are ready. We need just some music. But before announcing it, we would like to invite you all startups that were in the stage. Can you please join us? Thank you. We are all friends. We had a lot of memory during the Uplift journey. So we want to make a strong relationship between you. So we expect that this is going to last very, very long. The winner of the Uplift Albania 2020 and 21 edition is
Cross Flag. Congratulations.
And we are expecting the Cross Flag team to join the stage. You deserve. Congratulations. We need a picture, of course. We need some music as well in the background, just a little bit. And another statement.
I don't know. I don't have much to say. It's just like it's been really nice to be part of this cohort and meet all of you. And I hope that we'll be working together in the coming months with every startup. And definitely for anything that you think that we could help you out, please reach out. It would be an amazing.
There is another picture that is symbolic of the Uplift that we need to raise a little bit and then to have a picture. But someone have to count from 3, 2, 1. Yeah, is it okay? Ash, the mirror set up? Okay, po, do hidhe miliard, 1, 2, 3, kur bëhet 3, do hidhe miliard kështu.
Okay.
1, 2, 3. Woo! Is it okay?
Kushtrim, the girls are with heels, Kushtrim.
I'm sorry.
I'm talking on the other two, girls be held.
You had to count on this. Yeah, this is a tradition right now. Edhe një hapur para, okay. Okay, got it? 1, 2, 3. Thank you so much.
Thank you to everyone.
Greetings to anyone who followed Uplift Albania for this 4-month journey. See you in the next edition, but we will surprise you with some great events and great projects. Thank you so much and see you in the next event.
Thank you to everyone. It was a great pleasure, and I hope you had the same vibe as us in here. Thank you to all of you. Lërëni muzikën në sfond. Rime.